Hi, this is Emily from MinuteEarth. Domestication has puppified dogs, fluffified sheep, and spotified horses. But there's a less obvious physical change that virtually all domesticated animals share. Shrunken brains. Duck brains have shrunk by about 15%, cat brains by 30%, and pig brains by a whopping 35%. We've even found smaller brains in farmed trout. Which is weird because, in general, the size of animals' brains and the size of their bodies is super tightly linked. Mites have smaller brains than ants, which have smaller brains than mice, which have smaller brains than elephants, and so on. The same relationship exists for individuals within species. So, for example, small wolves have smaller brains than big wolves, and small dogs have smaller brains than big dogs. But when you compare wolves and dogs, between individuals of the same size, the wolves have bigger brains, no matter what that body size is. What's more, across different domesticated animals, a disproportionate amount of the shrinkage happened in parts of the brain that monitor information from the outside world and tell animals when and how to freak out, sort of like the brain's panic button. We know that in general, animals with bigger panic buttons have a more sensitive fight or flight response, and animals with smaller panic buttons are naturally tamer. So those are the ones we probably would have tried to domesticate. And by breeding the tamest animals with each other, we shrunk their panic buttons, and therefore their brains, even further. In short, domesticated animals have formed long-term partnerships with humanity by literally losing their minds.